Now we are going to discuss I-type instructions. So we are going to discuss I-type instructions. So let's see the format of I-type instruction. Again, I-type instruction will also contain 32-bit, as we have discussed previously that all MIPS instructions are 32-bit. So I-type instruction will also be of 32-bit. So let's see what are the fields that we have in any I-type instruction. We have opcode, which is going to be 6-bit. I'll write it later. Then we have RS, and then we have RT, and then we have offset. This could be RT, RD, it doesn't matter. The main thing is that we have one source and then we have one destination. Now, opcode, as always, opcode will be of 6-bit, RS would be 5-bit, RT would be of 5 bits, and the offset will be of 16 bits. So this is the general format of I-type instruction. Now let's have an example of I-type instruction. Let's say we have this instruction, add I, let's say 10 11 10. This is what we have. Now for this, before I encode this one, the high level equivalent of this one is something like this: x equal to y plus 10. So this is the high level equivalent of the of this instruction, where x will be in register 10, y will be in register 11, and this is our constant. Now, how can we encode this one? To encode this one, we need to identify the destination, source, and then the offset or the constant. So, as always, this is our destination, this is our source, and this is our constant. So, and this is of course our opcode. So what did I say about the opcode? That we do not have to memorize the opcode value or integer opcode value. For any opcode value, we do not have to memorize it. If it is given, then we'll convert it in the 6-bit binary value. And if it is not given, then we'll leave it like that. So since it is not given here, so we'll leave it like this. Now let's encode this one. As I said, that we'll be leaving opcode as it is, as a blank, or we could write this like this. So RS is 11. So this will be 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. And destination is 10. So this is 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. And our constant is also 10. This is 1 0 1 0. This is the equivalent representation of 10, and since this is positive, so we can write that all the remaining bits will be 0. So that means we have 1 2 3 4 bits that was required to represent this 10, and the remaining 12 bits will be 0. So the equivalent machine code for this one would be this: x, 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 and x, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then we have 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and then we have 12 zeros. So let's say from here to here, we have total 12 zeros, and then we have 1, 0, 1, 0. This is our machine code for this add I instruction, which is our I-type instruction. And the high-level equivalent is this. So again, this is our high-level code. This is our assembly. This is our assembly code, and this is our machine code. So this is how I-type instruction, by the way, this is I-type arithmetic operation. Now, we'll look another I-type instruction, which in this case, not arithmetic instruction. This is going to be a memory instruction. So, let me erase this one. Let me erase this one, even though we are again going to put this crosses in the opcode field, as we are not very much concerned about the opcode value, because we would like to have them in the question, or the opcode value will be provided, so we can automatically convert the integer value into the binary when the opcodes are given. So we are not actually bothered about the opcode value. Now let's say the formatting stays the same. So one memory operation, let's say the memory operation is load operation. So load 10, 40, or let's say 16, 11. This is one memory operation. Now, what is the interpretation of this assembly instruction into the high level code? First of all, let's see what the high level code would look like for this assembly code. So, the high level code would look like something like this. X would be Y 4. This is what the high level code would look like. Now, how did I get this? Whenever we have any integer value in this field, we'll divide it by 4. So, if we divide it by 4, that would give us the index of the array. So, if I divide it by 4, then I'll get 4. So, the index of the array is 4. And now, let's assume the array is Y itself. And this is our base address of the array. So, if I do the assignment here, then X would be in register 10. And the base address of this array would be in register 11. So, this is how the high level code would look like. Now, if we convert this into the machine instruction, so by the way, this is our this 11, register number 11 is our source. This is our 16 is our offset on this field, and register 10 is our destination. So, and this is opcode. As I said, that we are not going to be bothered about the value of the opcode, just put a 6 crosses here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, what is our source? Source is 11. So, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. This is our source. And what is our destination? This is 10. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. And what is our offset? This is 16. So, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So, this is 16. So, you have 5 bits. The rest of the bits, since this value is positive, so rest of the bits would be 0. Now, if I represent it here, then what would be the equivalent machine code for this assembly code or this high level code? The machine code would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, and then we have zeros here, and 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is our machine code for this assembly instruction and this high level code.